Hi, I'm Mark Lewandowski, biologist for DNR's Resource Assessment Service. We're here today to show boaters how to minimize the risk of spreading aquatic invasive species. By following a few simple steps, you can do your part and help to preserve Maryland's natural resources for future generations. A bit of mud, a droplet of water, or a tiny plant fragment is all it takes to spread harmful plants and animals. To minimize that risk, we're asking all residents and visitors to thoroughly inspect and clean vessels, trailers, and gear after each use. For trailers, this includes the bunks, wheel wells, wiring, and lights. For boats, you will need to check all surfaces, the engine, the prop, and the anchor. For personal watercraft and jet boats, you'll need to check the water intake and nozzle assembly as well. Deposit any foreign materials in a dedicated waste station or trash receptacle. Drain water from the boat, motor, bilge, live wells, and bait containers before leaving the launch, and always leave boat plugs out while traveling. Wash live wells with a mild bleach solution to kill plant fragments, fish eggs, and microscopic animals that could have been pumped into the boat. If you know the water body you are leaving has zebra or quagga mussels, please take your boat to a car wash and use high pressure and preferably hot water to clean the hull, engine, and trailer. If possible, allow your boat to dry for 5 days or more before launching in another water body. Also be sure to clean your fishing gear, tackle, and other recreational gear. Always dispose of worms, unwanted bait fish, and fish parts in the trash. Releasing live bait fish could promote the spread of disease. Taking just a few minutes after each trip can help prevent lasting damage to Maryland's beautiful waterways. Spread the word, not aquatic hitchhikers. Thanks very much for your help.